Welcome to the Dixie Belle YouTube channel. Today we're gonna be giving this little bedside table a moody and dramatic makeover. For a list of all the products I use in this video and where to buy them, be sure to check out the description box below. Now let's flip it. I've got my husband helping me out with some prep work today. So he's gonna take out all the drawers and mark them 1, 2, 3, 4 so we don't get them mixed up. Then he's gonna remove all the hardware so I can clean it up. We flip the piece upside down, take our vacuum and make sure that there's no dust or debris or any webs or anything like that. We also do the insides of the drawer cubbies just to make sure everything's nice and clean. Then we use our white lightning cleaner, which I already have mixed up in my little spray bottle here, and we wipe down the piece and just thoroughly give it a good cleaning. Once we're done with that, we wipe it down with a wet rag with water just to make sure there's no cleaner residue left on that piece. My next step is to fill in any of the holes or gouges or scratches with some Dixie Belle mud. And once the mud dries, which takes about an hour, I come back with my sanding sponge and I make sure everything is sanded nice and flush. Now I'm taping off the inside of the drawers so I can get some clean lines when I apply my paint. I've decided to prime the piece, so I'm gonna use Dixie Belle's Boss in the color gray. There's some discoloration in the wood, and I used the Dixie Belle mud, so I just wanna make sure everything's nice and even when I apply my paint. And I don't want there to be any stains showing through or odors or anything like that, so just to be on the safe side, I decided to add 2 coats of the Dixie Belle's Boss. I wait for it to dry about a half an hour in between the coats. Maybe more like an hour. But I apply it to everywhere that I'm going to apply my paint. Now, for the paint, right now I'm using Terra Clay Paint in the color Onyx. It's a really gorgeous dark black, and I'm using the oval mini brush to apply it. I really like the oval mini brush when I'm trying to blend the Terra Clay Paint colors. Terra Clay Paint is perfect for texture, so if you're looking for texture, you would want to use one of the natural bristle brushes. But I am looking for a softer blend on this, so I'm going with the synthetic bristles. I use my water mister in one hand and my brush in the other hand to apply the paint, and it goes on really nice. The next color I'm gonna use is the Terra Clay Paint in the color Galaxy, which is this gorgeous dark blue. I'm gonna try to blend them together in the middle, but I'm going down far enough to where Galaxy will just be on its own. And keep in mind, this is only the first coat. I add 2 coats to this piece, but when I'm using the Terra Clay Paint and I'm blending, I wait 24 hours in between my coats just to make sure that I'm not reactivating the first coat. Terra Clay Paint can reactivate with water, so if you make a mistake, you could just add your water, reactivate the paint, and blend it out or fix it however you want. But in this case, I want to do the first coat and then I want that to dry and just cure a tiny bit so that I don't reactivate it when I'm adding my second coat. I want to get some full coverage on this. My third color here is called Moonbeam, and it is a gorgeous white. And what I'm gonna do is add the Moonbeam to the bottom, very bottom of the piece, and then I'm gonna mix it in with that Galaxy and make a lighter blue shade so that we have this ombre effect going up the piece. So from light to dark. So I'm taking my Galaxy right now and I'm just bringing it down. And exactly what I do on this first coat, 24 hours later, I just follow the same exact steps. Right here, I was going back and forth because I was trying to decide how much of the white I want to keep on the piece. And the inspiration from this came from a dress that I had seen on Pinterest. And at the bottom of that dress, there was just a teeny tiny bit of white at the bottom. So that's what I ended up going with. Now I take the design from the front and I just swing it around to each side. But since my blend is on a curve, I'm gonna follow that curve throughout the piece. So on this side, there will be less black at the top and more white and lighter blue at the bottom. And then on the neck, and then the other side, the opposite side of the piece, I'm gonna have more black and just a little bit of white so that it matches the front of the piece. And I just love the blue that Galaxy and the Moonbeam make. It's such a gorgeous color. Now on the drawer fronts and the sides, I'm using the Victorian Damask stencil with the Dixie Belle Mud in black. This is gonna give me that raised stencil effect. I just carefully apply the mud to the stencil with a putty knife, just being careful not to let the stencil lift. We don't want any of the mud to go underneath the stencil, but if you just push it down with one hand and apply it with the other hand, you should be totally fine. I'm trying to keep the amount of mud that I use pretty consistent because I don't want there to be a bunch of peaks and valleys, and I don't want to have to sand the mud down once it dries. So here I'm just going back through each of the rows to make sure that it's pretty flat and that it's pretty even. There's not a lot of chunks or anything. Then I carefully take the stencil off and I'm left with a beautiful raised stencil. Now while I wait for that to dry, I'm gonna go back in. I take all the drawers out and I'm gonna touch up the insides of the drawers. I'm gonna use Galaxy on most of them just so that I have a nice even application. And that just makes for a really nice, neat project. Then once I've applied my stencil to the sides and it's dry, I come back the next day and I'm gonna do the top of the piece. I still haven't even done the top of the piece, and I decided to go with the Terra Clay Paint in Onyx. I do three really light coats of Onyx on the top for full coverage. Now my next step is to add a satin clear coat to the whole piece. And I want to do this because I love that how the satin deepens the color, and because the Dixie Belle mud dries in a light gray, when I put the satin coat on, it deepens the mud too. So I apply three coats of the satin clear coat in total, waiting an hour in between coats. Here it is, all finished. I added some new hardware to the piece. And I have to say, there were so many times where I thought I was going to add some silver to this, but the gorgeous raised stencil with the black mud was just enough to give it everything it needed, in my opinion. I love it. I really love this piece. I'd love to know what you think about it down in the comments, and I will see you next time with another furniture makeover.